Hey everybody, this is Perch, and it turns out the creator of Jinny Hex, a one-shot, has gotten everybody angry. And you might be saying, what did Mags do? No, it's not Mags. Mags is the author of Jinny Hex, who had a really profoundly strange hype interview that went out on Newsarama that was just weird on a lot of different levels. I'm reminded that if old Daniel Cherry wants to kind of put some of that marketing PR acumen to the table, that maybe he should hire some people to come in and give some classes. You can do it by Zoom now. Like, you can pay not much for some kind of social media training. Here's how you can kind of talk to. Here's when you're going to do an interview. Here's some things you can say that kind of promotes the company, makes yourself look better. Here's some things to avoid. Like, I get spam all the time for things. So one of the things I'm getting spam is public speaking for Zoom interviews and calls. Now that you're stuck at home and you're doing these things, here's some corporate training for how to do that. That'd be a good, wise investment. I'm just saying, for any publisher, a very wise investment. By the way, I'm going to do another video. Some people are asking me, hey, you had a very middle of the road kind of take on Daniel Cherry. What do you think now? Seems like a disaster and so on. And I'll do a video. I'll talk a little bit about kind of a report card where we are from here. I still think, just the headlines, it's early to say on some of this stuff, because a lot of these comics and books and other things were commissioned 6 months or more ago. If you heard the interview with Jeffrey Thorne, I mean, he's talking about a Green Lantern pitch that's more than a year old, and it's going to come out in April of next year. So it'll be like a year and a half old by then. Maybe not quite that long. It'll be old is the point. And so a lot of stuff predated him. And so I think we have yet to see what his fingerprints are like on that kind of stuff. But what isn't too late to determine is he was primarily hired, at least part of the fanfare of his hiring was that he was a big marketing guy. He knew how to package, promote, and really do a better job with marketing and messaging. And 3 months into the job, I think we can officially kind of say on that one, and that is to say, has he taken the job yet? Because if so, completely asleep at the wheel. I think the marketing remains, especially after that March rollout, like an F. I mean, there's no other better way to put it than just very, very bad messaging. Anyway, but this video isn't about that. This video is about Gleb Melnikov, who is the artist for Jinny Hex, has done a few different DC things, done some work for Superman, done some work on Wonder Woman, Batman the Outsiders, Angel and Spike. So a lot of comics. Actually has had a pretty busy year, all things considered, given everything else, has had a pretty busy year. Anyway, he basically tweets out, always the source of all trouble, please don't do this. You have 20 pages of superhero comic. You don't want to waste three of them on the exact same face over and over again. And he posted this some pages from Venom. And I think he's just kind of commenting on the industry. I mean, why not, right? And basically, he's kind of making fun of the 9-panel talking head bit, although I think it was not 9 panels, it was 6 panels. Anyway, the idea of these kind of talking heads. For the record, this is not an outlandish, crazy opinion. What's funny, and as I get to it, because a bunch of other creators and the hangers-on to creators all dogpile onto Gleb, they amazingly, there's a lot of toxic creatordom that goes on here with this tweet. But if you go further back to when Brian Michael Bendis was doing these talking head panels in the Avengers, and particularly when the Avengers relaunched the new number one issue, I would say this is 2012, maybe. I may have the year completely wrong, but this was the golden age that it was the launch after the Dark Reign ended, and we had Siege, and then we had a brand new Avengers number one, and there was several double page spreads of just talking heads. And there was a lot of criticism. What's interesting about that is there was a lot of criticism on CBR and on Bleeding Cool, who were talking about how, you know, this kind of the overuse of the talking head, what they were comparing it to was reality TV show, kind of the stationary camera confessional type thing. And that you've got all this stuff to show action, and you're wasting a talent like John Romita Jr. on talking heads. What's interesting is some of the people who wrote those comments are now comic creators themselves and are vigorously angry at Gleb Melnikov, who go all over the map of accusing him of being comics-gate and terrible and a hateful person. And, you know, here's old Jamal Engel with the, I absolutely disagree with this. There are no rules. You know, Mitch Gerard's come in with some 90s bullshit. Comic has evolved. Alex DeCampi is angry. You know, you know, Tom King decides to post his stuff. I wonder if he knows that Gleb Melnikov is not Asian. Oh, anyway, whatever. I'm joking. Anyway, so then there's some good comedy. Al Kennedy comes out with a good, you have 20 pages of superhero comics. 10 of them always lie. 10 of them always tell the truth. You have one question. That's funny. But anyway, it is a lot of thoughts here. So number one, you know, this isn't a new opinion. I do have to laugh inwardly and maybe cry a little bit inwardly about people throwing this out as some new shocking comics opinion that nobody has ever said before, because some of the names on this list have voiced similar concerns. I'm just throwing it out there in the past. But now it's some new person saying this. I don't know. Maybe he didn't. Maybe Gleb Melnikov didn't put in his dues for, I mean, he's listing himself as the CEO of Halloween, so maybe that's being too big for his britches. I don't know. It's gross. I hate that. I hate the reverse tagging and everything else. It's an interesting kind of dynamic. Number one, this isn't going to promote Jinny Hex. I'll just put that out there. It is what it is. I think that it is, I mean, it's a take, right? You can ignore it. You can, not ignore it. This is somebody's take. I don't think it was said in spite. I don't think it was said in wrongness. It is what it is. What is gross about it was the response, and the responses are just toxic. I mean, there's probably no better way to put it. There's just a lot of very angry, very people who, rather than say, well, you know, I disagree, storytelling could be a different way, there's like, shut the F up, you stupid moron. There is, I love it when some newcomer to the industry tries to tell us what to do. Go screw yourself. I mean, just disappointing. I'm disappointed, comics world. You know, you could do whatever you want. Obviously, there's all kinds of different ways to tell stories. I think there's a difference between kind of overuse of the format or not. Again, getting back to the Bendis Avengers book, where it was kind of that talking head at the camera business. I mean, at the time, reality TV shows were starting to definitely feel tired. And so the whole format seemed kind of copycatting and lame. I get, you know, look at it this way. I'll look at this guy's comment, this Gleb Melnikov's comment, and think, you know, maybe he's just voicing an opinion that he'd like to see more action in the comics. Is that a crime? Is that terrible? I don't know. You don't want to waste three of them doing the, please don't do this. I guess, God, is this where our industry has come to, that a very timid kind of comment of please don't do this? You have 20 pages of superhero comic. You don't want to waste three of them on the exact same face over and over again. That's a crime against all comic nature. I mean, I don't know. I mean, did we need all those Heroes in Crisis bits where you have Clayman art with characters just staring into the camera and talking over and over and over and over again? I mean, you don't have to do that. I mean, you may love it. I don't know. It's up to you. I just don't think it's any kind of horrifying, terrible, awful stuff to basically say, I think this style sucks. Again, wasn't calling Mark Bagley. Mark Bagley, who mysteriously didn't weigh in on any of this, most likely because he's busy drawing like a maniac. Donnie Cates weighs in, but does the thing where he comments on it, but then he doesn't say who he's commenting on. So then he gets a bunch of people in the replies talking about, oh, you're talking about this asshole. And it just, it's all gross. This is toxic creator dumb. It's the best way to put it. Emphasis on the dumb. For what it's worth, I've seen plenty of artists and creators pull this off, and it adds to the story, and it's a pause beat to the story, and it works. You can do it where it works. It's also a style that has been overused lately, and I don't like it. So I think it can go either way. It's does the story demand it or call for it or not? It can be as simple as that. It doesn't need to be more complicated than that. But apparently, it is toxic creatordom on Twitter today, and eat your own, which is the way it goes. Anyway, what do you think? Talking heads and comics, bad, good, a waste, love it, hate it, don't care. Let me know in the comments below. Like and subscribe. Follow me on social media where I complain about all kinds of things all the time. Toxic perchdom, I guess. Anyway, thanks for listening.